perhaps you're taking thyroid medication like Synthroid or Levothyroxine or Tyrosine, and you're not really feeling a whole lot better, right? Your TSH won't stabilize. One month it's too high, the next month it's too low, and really whatever changes your doctor makes, you really still don't feel good. You're still struggling with so many symptoms that you were hoping and told that the thyroid medication would fix. Well, let's get back to some of the basics and explain why this is happening when you take Synthroid or Levothyroxine or Tyrosine. The first thing you need to understand is that these are synthetic man-made laboratory hormones called T4, thyroxine. And T4 is the main hormone produced by our thyroid glands. Most of it you can't use, it's just inactive. What needs to happen is that your body needs to convert this T4 into something called T3. T3 makes the magic happen in the body. It helps you lose weight, helps you burn fat, increases your energy, helps your hair, skin, and nails grow. It's important for digestion. It's important for gut motility. It even influences your gut microbiome and plays a major role in maintaining the gut barrier, okay? And the list goes on and on. Now, as important as T3 is, you may wonder why more doctors and endocrinologists really have no interest in understanding one of the biggest areas that your thyroid gets hung up. Sometimes I almost think that your doctors and endocrinologists have really just been teleported back into the 50s and 60s rather than try to get up to speed and try to understand why the thyroid is failing. Too often patients come to me with thyroid issues, and yet despite taking Synthroid and Levothyroxine, they really feel no better than when they first got diagnosed with thyroid disease. Often what I see is that their doctors check their TSH levels. Sometimes they check T4, but they almost never look at T3 or free T3 levels. If they did check T3 and free T3 levels, every single time they check TSH, what they would see is that one of the reasons their patients still feel lousy despite taking the thyroid replacement is that their patients' T3 and free T3 levels are low. Now, this is a major problem and a cause of persistent hypothyroid symptoms like hair loss and fatigue and weight gain and depression and anxiety and miscarriages and all kinds of gut problems. Well, if I piqued your attention, stay tuned, because throughout this video series, I'm going to explain some of the root causes as to why you're not converting T4 into T3 and what you need to do to improve low T3 hormone levels so that you can start feeling good again. Now, when I mention T3, keep in mind that this hormone comes from really three main areas, right? While the thyroid itself produces small amounts of T3, that's not really where we find the majority of it. Most of it is made in the liver and kidneys, thanks in part to a group of enzymes called deiodinase enzymes. For this reason, liver damage or chronic kidney disease are both associated with impaired thyroid hormone conversion, and this results in reduced circulating levels of T3. Not only can thyroid disease cause liver problems, but problems in the liver can impair this T4 to T3 conversion. And when it comes to kidney disease, here again, it's common to see low T3 levels because the kidney is one of the sites where T4 to T3 takes place. Now, when you have chronic kidney disease or any other kind of chronic health condition, once this inflammation becomes systemic, these inflammatory chemicals begin to impair these enzymes that are again responsible for this conversion. So in a nutshell, one way to improve the conversion of T4 to T3 is to improve liver and kidney function. And this can be done with diet, it can be done with supplements, it can be done with natural herbs. We do it all the time in our office. Now, in upcoming videos, I'm going to talk about the other reasons you're not converting T4 into T3. But remember, conversion issues are one of the most common reasons for low T3. And a conversion issue may be one of the reasons that, despite taking Synthroid or Levothyroxine or Tyrosine, it may be one of the reasons you still feel lousy. All right, so there you go. If you have questions about today's video, drop them in the comment section below. I'll do my best to try to answer those questions for you. If you have interest in working with my clinic, you can reach out to me by visiting my website. There's also a free guide. If you haven't downloaded that free guide, you can actually go to my website and click on the section, one of the tabs that says free guides. And lastly, if you like today's video, after you give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my YouTube channel, I recommend that you watch this video on the other ways to improve T3 hormone levels next.